and the lost.
Unfortunately, the land down under has seen a major decline in professed Christianity in recent years.
Thankfully, YWEA 2024 has developed an aggressive plan to open the doors of a thriving church. The Church of God will plant a church in the heart of Sydney, Australia, near Sydney University. We will passionately pursue an emerging generation of Australians for God's glory and rewrite the narrative for Australia through church planting and revitalisation.
The island of Fiji is filled with many opportunities to serve the needs of children and their families. Many children in Fiji face an uphill battle when it comes to education, food, proper care, and the most basic needs in life. The mortality rate in children under 5 years old is near 20%.
YWEA 2024 is teaming up with a former Fijian rugby star turned Church of God minister who's making an eternal difference in the streets of Fiji. This project will revolve around meeting the daily and most basic life needs of Fijians.
YWEA will offer help, hope, and healing to a generation that so desperately needs God. We will also be supporting a Church of God Bible school that is raising up pastors and leaders to reach Fiji for the kingdom.
New Zealand is facing a major epidemic of suicide in its teenage and young adult population that is crippling future generations. Tragically, New Zealand has one of the highest adolescent suicide rates in the entire world.
While this epidemic is a heart-wrenching problem, Church of God Youth and Discipleship is committed to finding a solution.
YWEA 2024 will establish a Church of God Crisis Care and Ministry Training Centre in Papakaio, New Zealand.
The care centre will be staffed with leaders who are properly trained in counselling that will hear the cries of a generation and offer them a blessed hope.
We will also be launching Winterfest New Zealand and have expectations to see God save, deliver, and fill Church of God students in this region.
As the sun is setting here in Papakaio Community Church of God, my heart is full thinking about the difference that's going to be made in 2024 with our YWA project. I just can't wait to see what God does when we're all said and done. I want to say from the bottom of my heart, thank you for your financial support. Thank you more than anything for your prayers. Those two things combined are going to make the difference. We love you, we appreciate you, and from the bottom of our hearts, we just want to say thank you. God bless you, and we'll see you soon.
West Toronto Church of God invites you to its 52nd Easter Convention under the theme Finished, Friday, March 29 to Sunday, March 31, with Bishop One and Lady Jenny Garcia. Come join us for an anointed, spirit-filled outpouring here at 1655 Wilson Avenue. See you there.
Put a name. Put a name. Put a name on that thing you're going to do.
YWEA 2024. Restoring hope, reclaiming lives.
Isaiah.
Every oppression. Every depression.
Welcome back to our 52nd Eastern Convention. We are glad you guys are all here to celebrate Jesus' sacrifice on the cross for all of our sins.
We anticipate another great session of worship and fellowship, so we invite you to humble your hearts as we're about to receive the word. So without further ado,
let's get back into our service.
Amen.
Every oppression.
We are in your presence. Thank you.
hallelujah, hallelujah. Go ahead and worship the Lord, church. Go ahead and worship the Lord tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The presence of the Lord is in this house. And we welcome the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And all of you, my brothers and sisters, the angel of this house, Bishop Vernon, Lady Vernon, and our guest speaker and his wife, and all the ministers in the house, welcome this evening. What a joy it is to be celebrating this very special weekend. We call it Easter, but guess what? Jesus is not in the grave. He's alive. Amen, somebody. He's alive. Amen. And West Toronto, we are come this evening to celebrate with you the 52nd convention of the West Toronto Church of God. Amen. Give the Lord a hand of praise in this house. To God be the glory. Amen, amen. I'm excited just as you are tonight. And we're going to pray and just allow the praise team to continue to lead us in worship. So let's bow together as we worship the Lord. Heavenly Father, with grateful hearts, we are bowed together in thy presence. We want to say thank you for bringing us here this evening. Lord, you have graced us today with your presence. And we are come the second time for the day to worship and to praise you again. Our hearts are filled with gratitude, with thanksgiving, with appreciation, and with celebration to know that you have conquered death, hell, and the grave. Hallelujah! Lord, we praise you because you are alive. And we worship you tonight. Thank you for bringing us here tonight from far and from near. And Lord, we invite your presence to be with us in every aspect of this service. Be glorified tonight. We know if the devil would have the opportunity to disrupt the service, he would. But we take authority over the principalities and powers, and we bind them in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And we declare that you are Lord over this atmosphere, over this service, in all that we do and say tonight. Be glorified, God. Touch your people. Minister to each person as we open our hearts and worship you. We tell you thanks now for hearing us in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And let the church say, amen, amen, and amen.
And our scripture reading tonight is from St. John 19, verse 28 to 37. St. John 19, verse 28 to 37 from the King James Version. After this, Jesus, knowing that all things were now accomplished, that the scripture might be fulfilled, said, I thirst. Now therefore was set a vessel full of vinegar, and they filled the sponge with vinegar, and put it upon hyssop, and put it in his mouth. When Jesus therefore had received the vinegar, he said, it is finished. And he bowed his head and gave up the ghost. The Jews therefore, because it was the preparation that the body should not remain upon the cross on the Sabbath day, for the Sabbath day was an high day, besought Pilate that their legs might be broken and that they might be taken away. Then came the soldiers and brake the legs of the first and of the other which was crucified with him. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was dead already, they brake not his legs. But one of the soldiers with a spear pierced his side, and forthwith came there out blood and water. And he that saw it bear record, and his record is true, and he knoweth that he said truth, that he might believe. For these things were done, that the scripture should be fulfilled: a bone of him shall not be broken. 37 and last. And again, another scripture said, they shall look on him whom they pierce. The word of God is blessed, and we say, amen.
Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We're in the house of the Lord another time to give him praise, to give him glory, and to give him honor. Anybody ready to praise the Lord? Now turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, it's good to see you tonight. You're looking lovely tonight. But I'm going to ask you very kindly. No, tell him, I'm going to ask you very kindly to give me a little space, because I'm about to get my praise on. Hallelujah. Here we go. We've come to praise the Lord. We've come to lift our hands, to sing, to shout, to dance, and to exalt the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. We come here to praise. We come here to praise. We come here to praise the Lord. We come here to sing, shout, and clap our hands. Praise the Lord. We come here to lift up his holy name. We come here to praise the Lord. We come to spread the gospel to the world and praise the Lord. Sing, we come. We come here to praise. We come here to praise. We come here to praise the Lord. We come here to sing and shout and clap our hands and praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord
for health and strength and sweet. to lift up his holy name. We've come to praise the Lord. It is our only response for all that he has done. It is our response for who he is, to worship him in spirit and in truth. Because of his love for us. Ah, God. Oh, that overwhelming love, that reckless love that he has shown for us. What is your response tonight? Your response may be a hallelujah. Your response can be a thank you, Jesus. Your response may be a tear. Your response may be a moan or a groan, because he understands. But it is our duty to honor the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, somebody. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Yeah. Abia. belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to only you. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. Belongs to only you. your presence in this place tonight, God. Yahweh. 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 One last time, let's declare Yahweh. And above the earth. Can we just lift our hands towards heaven one time and just adore the name of the Lord?
Just lift those hands and just continue to worship the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. Thank you, sweet Holy Spirit, for tabernacling among us. Hallelujah. You may be seated if you can. Praise God. As we continue our worship, my brothers and sisters, hallelujah, I want to extend a very warm welcome to all of us in this sanctuary and for all individuals worshiping with us online. At West Toronto, we like to worship. And the music is rich. And the worship is even richer, right? So when we come into the presence of the Lord, we are here
to worship. Amen? Amen. Today, or this evening, I want to acknowledge the presence of our lead pastor and our First Lady, Bishop Wayne Vernon and Lady Yvonne Vernon. I'm going to kindly ask them to stand, turn around, wave, and greet you, Bishop Wayne and Lady V. Thank you. We want to also acknowledge our guest speakers, Bishop Juan Garcia and Jenny Garcia. Could you kindly stand, please? Praise God. A little later on, Bishop Vernon will tell you more about the Garcias. We want to acknowledge the presence of our ministers who serve along with our pastor and first lady. So, ministers of the West Toronto Church of God, could you please stand and be acknowledged? For my colleague, council men and women, could you please stand? We support our pastor. To all our churches on the West Toronto District of Churches, we want to acknowledge you. And so may I invite Bishop Clifton and Lady Hall and the members of Covenant of Promise to stand, please, and be acknowledged. Thank you. Bishop Trevor Brown and Lady Brown and the members of Temple of Praise, could you please stand and be acknowledged? The youth church on the district, Bishop Damien Riley and Lady Riley from Refuge Nation, could you please stand and be acknowledged? Reverend Charlene and son, they're here representing Victory Tabernacle. Thank you. And I don't know if Minister or Reverend Mackenzie from Yahweh Ministry is here. If you're here, could you please stand? Okay. We want to also acknowledge some other ministers worshiping with us. I see Bishop and Lady Bent. Could you please stand, Bishop? Thank you. Thank you, Lady Bent. We have Bishop Lyndon Brown. I know him from Jamaica, you know. Put your hands together for him. All right. And I hope I'm not missing anyone. So if you are a visiting minister worshiping with us today, and I miss you, I didn't mean to, but I'm going to kindly ask you to stand so that you can be acknowledged, visiting ministers. All right, so amen. We have quite a few. Thank you for being here with us at West Toronto. So some 50-something years ago, we'll say 50-plus years ago, under the distinguished leadership of Bishop or Reverend Clifford MacDonald and Ina MacDonald, we started this great denomination. And you see my shirt, what it says, I love my West Toronto. Yeah, yeah. So there are some persons who are worshiping, they're members of this great church, like persons like Brother Samuel Cockett. Could you please stand, Brother Cockett? Brother Cockett has not missed one Easter convention. This is our 52nd Easter convention, and he has been at all of the conventions. Brother Buzz, I don't see Brother, oh, Buzz. Brother Buzz, Deacon Emeritus, right at the back there. Brother Buzz, is he hearing me? All right, put your hands together for our Brother Buzz. You have some, I would call them 49ers. They are 49 and below. I've been here at West Toronto for these many, many years, even older than, oh, well, yes. Persons like Sister Jackson, Sister Allen, Brother Allen, right? And Sister Mavis. They have not missed a beat as it relates to our Easter convention. You see these young man, that young man over there, the was McKay, and you have persons like Jason and Janice, who again? Sister Angela, the Reed, and the Reeds, all of them. So, in case I miss you, I didn't mean to miss you. But we are happy that you have laid the foundation so we can continue to worship the Lord. I want to welcome our Hispanic ministries under the leadership of Oswe and Estrella. Put your hands together for them and all the members of the Hispanic ministry. Praise God. Thank you to Brother Marlon Campbell and Sister Anesta and Caleb. They are leading the ministry out there in London. The London Campus Brethren, they were here with us. They are worshiping with us online, but their leaders are here, and so we want to acknowledge them. My friend, my brothers and sisters, today we had an awesome time in the presence of the Lord. Amen? And tonight we are anticipating to go higher or deeper or whatever in the inner courts, right? And we're going to worship God and give him all the glory. Thank you for choosing West Toronto this weekend to be your place of worship. We love our West Toronto. God bless you.
You know, when you see me come up here after the welcome, you know what it is, right? It is. We know what it is, yes? We know what time it is? Do we know what time it is? So, you know, for tomorrow and for Sunday morning and Sunday evening, once you see me come up here after the welcome, you know what time it is. So you just stand and get yourself ready, right? Hallelujah. Let's go. We're going to be doing our theme song. It is finished. Woo. Yeah, yeah.
Sing. Oh, 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 oh. When the enemy thought he was winning.
West Toronto Church of God. God bless you today. Pastor Wayne Vernon and First Lady Yvonne, I want to say how delighted I am to
The Lord, not your neighbor, but praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Do you have a hallelujah for God this evening? Hallelujah! Hallelujah! It is finished. He is alive. I want you to touch yourself and say, it is finished. He is alive. I want you to shout it loud. It is finished. He is alive. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Are we enjoying the presence of God? Oh, glory to the Lamb of God. My name is Marlon Jarrett, and I have the distinct honor of leading us in giving. Don't get silent on me now, you know. Are we still in worship? Okay. Bless the Lord. In this, our 52nd convention, we are celebrating the greatest act of giving. When Christ Jesus laid down his life to afford us eternal life with him. Amen? So I invite you now to open your hearts and pockets and join us in giving, not sparingly nor grudgingly, but cheerfully and willingly. Amen? We're not asking for $5, $10, $1,000, or $1 million. No. As the Spirit leads you. Amen? Because you and God know how much you have to give and what you can give. Amen? Amen. To our beloved members of West Toronto, please remember your convention love gift. Please use the envelopes marked for convention offering. Amen? For your convenience, we have several options in place for your to facilitate your giving. You can mail your gifts. You can use Interact. You can go online, and we have point of sale machines. And you can text 647-696-0422, and you can scan the QR codes. So we have options for everyone. Amen. For those in the sanctuary, you can pay attention to the QR codes or the point of sale machines at the door. We ask that you be attentive to the ushers and their instructions, as they will guide you along to ensure that there is a seamless flow to present your offerings here at the altar. Bless the Lord. Let us pray. Father, thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We are here not because we have done anything good, but it's because of your grace and your mercies and your love and kindness. We are here this evening. And so, Father, we say thank you. We quiet our hearts and we say thank you, Abba. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for life in you, Christ Jesus. And as we are about to give to you, Lord God Almighty, I pray, Father, that we'll give from our hearts, Lord God Almighty. We'll give as you lead us to give, Father. Lord, I pray that you'll be with us. I pray that your anointing will be upon us. I pray that your presence will envelop us in this place, even now, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, we lift our hearts to you. We worship you, we glorify you, we magnify you, we exalt your name, because indeed you are an awesome God. You are the only true and living God. And so we worship you in spirit and in truth, even now. Father, we bless your name. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Thank you, 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 Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. We are grateful, Jesus. Thank you. We give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. In Jesus' precious name, amen. Bless your hearts.
So as we worship together, let us stand as we follow the direction of our ushers and worship and sing along.
Lift up my voice
from
my heart
with
all of
every tongue confess that you are Lord of all.
Hallelujah. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. These are the times when I wish I could sing. Because, man, I would be up here singing, hallelujah, hallelujah. Give praise unto the Lamb of God. But even though I can only make a joyful noise unto the Lord like many others of you, we're going to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. You don't need a chord. You don't need a run. You don't need anything to be able to say hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Give him your best praise because your hallelujah belongs to him. Shout your hallelujah to the Lamb of God and give him glory in the house. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. 52 years. This church has been hosting this convention 52 years, half of a century. Can you imagine that? Many have come, many have gone, many have switched churches, many have gone to other ministries. Many have gone to grasses that look greener. And all it has turned out to be is green carpet. But you have stuck with it. Can you imagine that there are people here who were in that first convention 52 years ago? And they've reared their families in this church. And some of those kids are now adults rearing their families in this church. What a blessing. Man, it is something to give God praise for. It is good to see all of you in the house tonight. It's good to see Bishop Garfield, our regional youth and Christian education director. I'm going to ask him to stand. Bishop Garfield, welcome. We missed you. And the Hispanic ministries from Cambridge. Is that Cambridge? Cambridge. Reverend Lloyd, I see Reverend Carlos. I'm going to ask you to stand, the Hispanic brethren from Cambridge, Ontario. Praise God. Good to have you. And it's just good to see all of you. I hope we didn't miss anyone. I'm making sure that you're here. You know, we're seeing our brethren from Windsor, Ontario, close to the U.S. border. But they're here, and we're happy that they're here. And all of you who are online worshiping tonight, we're so happy to have you. Well, what do you know? Years do fly very fast. You know, they go by very quickly. Bishop Garfield, I remember when, you know, we were much younger. Bishop Juan Garcia and I, we were youth directors in those days. He in the States, I was in Jamaica and the Cayman Islands. And we did some great ministries together as he supported our ministry back in Jamaica with our youth congress. He was introduced to us by Bishop Daniel Vassell. You know, every time I think about it, I wonder who is it that Daniel didn't introduce me to? You know, all of those who are friends of mine, I think Daniel Vassell introduced me to them, and to God be the glory. Bishop Juan and Jenny Garcia are the administrative bishop and the first lady of the Church of God, Hispanic Northeast. And he is an ordained bishop and she's an ordained minister of the Church of God. These are two choice servants of God who gave their lives to Christ early and began serving early. Can you imagine? I keep, you know, giving God thanks that I was 18 and a half when I went to Bible school. You know, but he began serving at age 13 under the mentorship of his father, Bishop Antonio Garcia, in New York City. And God has used him in so many, many ways through the years. And Sister Jenny herself was a product of the ministry as well. And she led Sunday school ministries in Spanish Harlem, New York. They are New Yorkers, but of Puerto Rican descent, so don't let them fool you, okay? Yes, yes. Yeah, they got the connection, all right? And they have been used by God as preachers in various ministries, and God has really blessed them to be together for 36 years. Put your hands together for 36 years of wonderful marriage, and we're thankful to God for all the ministries and church-based boards that they are involved in. And like I said, they are leading the Hispanic Northeast region of the Church of God, just mentoring and equipping people and discipling the generations. They have produced as well. They are parents, proud parents of three wonderful children. And they are now grandparents to four. I got to do something about my three. I've got to step it up, step up the game. And they're just happy to have their daughter-in-law and their son-in-law and their four wonderful grandchildren. My brothers and sisters, it is just an honor and privilege to have them with us this evening. During the pandemic, when we had our convention, Bishop Garcia, he spoke. And he spoke bilingually, you know, online. He was preaching in English and preaching in Spanish. And there was nobody inside here except myself and the tech team. But he was just preaching. You were here, Vicky? Oh, yeah. Thank you for being here. I don't remember seeing you, but you may have been here in spirit. But, you know, he ministered so powerfully that you would have thought he was in the building. And we give God thanks for them. After the song of preparation, Bishop Juan Garcia and Lady Jenny Garcia are going to be ministering to us. And when they come, we're going to ask you to stand and welcome this anointed couple of God, this dynamic duo. God bless you.
You're worthy of it all. You're worthy of it all. For from you are all things, and through you are all things. You deserve the glory. You're worthy. From you are all things, and
and sing. You're worthy of it all. Yes, you're worthy of it all. Far from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory.
Far from you are. Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Bendecido sea el nombre de Jesús.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Bendecido sea el nombre de Jesús.
You know, I've figured out that there are two categories of churchgoers.
Yo he aprendido que hay dos clases de gentes que van a la iglesia, que asisten a la iglesia.
And those two categories are here today.
Y esas dos categorías están aquí en esta noche.
One may outnumber the other.
Y uno puede sobrenumerar el otro.
But they're both here.
Pero los dos están presentes en esta noche.
La primera categoría.
And the first category is
aquellos que llegan al templo.
Those that come to the temple.
Porque se sienten obligados a venir al templo.
Because they feel obligated to be in the house.
Hoy es Viernes Santo.
Today is Good Friday.
Y como buen cristiano.
And like the good Christian you are.
Tú crees que debe de estar presente.
You believe that you've got to be present.
Esa categoría.
That category.
Necesariamente no vienen para adorar.
Doesn't necessarily come to worship.
Quizás están un poco heridos.
Maybe they're a little bit hurt.
Quizás están un poco cansados.
Maybe a little bit tired.
O es posible.
Or maybe it's just possible.
Que ellos no tienen ninguna razón.
That they don't even have a reason.
Para darle a Dios lo que él es digno de recibir.
To give God what he's worthy to receive.
So cuando llegan al templo.
So when they come to the house or to the temple.
Son los que cruzan sus brazos.
They're the ones that sit with their arms crossed.
A ver qué es lo que va a pasar.
To see what's going to happen in here.
A ver qué viento lo va a mover.
To see what wind is going to push them today.
A ver cómo van a ser provocados.
To see how they can be provoked today.
A ver si es verdad que Dios va a hacer algo nuevo.
To see if it's true that God could do something new.
Esa categoría.
That category.
De persona.
Of prayer people.
Salen como entraron.
They leave as they arrive.
Pero está la segunda categoría.
But then there's the second category.
Que no pueden dejar de decir.
That can't stop saying.
Mira lo que ha hecho Jehová.
Look what the Lord has done.
Esta categoría.
This category.
Entiende que todavía él está sentado en el trono.
Understands that he is still seated on the throne.
Es la categoría.
That category.
Que no importa lo que ha pasado.
Even doesn't matter what has happened to them.
No importa si están enfermos.
It doesn't matter if they're sick.
No importa si están cansados.
Or if they're tired.
No importa si están agotados.
Or if they're just drained.
No importa.
It doesn't matter.
Si el tiempo afuera está malo.
Because if the weather is bad.
No importa.
It doesn't matter.
Si los hijos.
If their children.
No se están comportando bien.
Going crazy.
No importa.
It doesn't matter.
Si pelearon con su esposo o esposa antes del culto.
If they argued with their husband or wife before they came through those
cuando
doors.
Cuando entraron por las puertas.
But when they came through those doors.
Ellos entienden.
They understood.
Que entraron por los atrios.
That they entered into the gates.
Donde hay un Dios.
Where there's a God.
Él es digno.
That is worthy.
Él es digno.
That is worthy.
Él es digno.
That is worthy.
Yo dije, él es digno.
I said he's worthy.
Y sin nadie decirle nada.
And without nobody telling you anything.
Espontáneamente.
Spontaneously.
Levanta sus manos.
They lift their hands.
Levanta su rostro.
They lift their eyes.
Y lo ofrecen a Dios.
And they offer to God.
Gritos de júbilo.
Shout of praise. Hallelujah! Woo!
Dígale a su vecino.
Come on and tell your neighbor.
Yo sé qué categoría yo soy.
I know what category I am.
¿Cuál será tu categoría?
What's your category?
Yo estoy seguro por qué yo estoy aquí.
I'm sure of why I'm here.
But why have you come to the house?
Pero ¿por qué ha llegado usted?
I know what I'm doing.
Yo sé lo que estoy haciendo.
I know who I am worshiping.
Yo sé a quién yo le estoy adorando.
What have you come for?
¿Para qué viniste usted? Woo! Come on. Hallelujah.
Tu respuesta hará la diferencia.
Your response is going to make the difference.
No es la música.
It's not the music.
No es los cánticos.
It's not the songs.
No es los gritos de esta pareja loca.
It's not the screams of this, the shouting of this crazy couple right here.
Es la disposición de tu corazón.
It's the disposition of your heart.
¿Dónde está tu corazón?
Where is your heart?
Ahí estará tu alabanza.
That's where your praise is.
La condición de tu corazón.
But the condition of your heart
determinará tu alabanza.
Will determine your praise.
Se atreven a darle 5 segundos.
Come on, do you dare give God 5 seconds of praise?
5 segundos.
5 seconds of praise.
Si necesita 10.
If you need 10.
Tomen 10.
I'll give you 10.
Si necesita 15.
If you need 15.
Toma la libertad.
Come on and take liberty in this place.
Pero darle lo que le es digno
de recibir. But come on and give God what he's worthy to receive. Hallelujah! You're worthy! You're worthy! You're worthy! Ain't nobody like Jesus!
No hay nadie como
Jesus. Ain't nobody like Jesus!
No hay nadie como
hey! Hey! It is finished! It is
consumado
finished!
Es.
It is finished!
Consumado
it
es.
Is finished!
Consumado es.
Come on, Bishop.
A mí me dijeron que yo estoy en mi casa.
Somebody told me that I'm at home.
Que estoy en mi casa.
That I'm in my home.
Y le voy a dar un secreto.
And I want to give you a secret.
Me siento como estoy en mi casa.
I feel like I'm at home.
Perdónenme.
Forgive me.
Aquellos que son demasiados muy toman muy importante.
Those of you that
give importance.
Give importance.
Más importancia.
More importance.
Al protocolo.
To protocol.
So para que no vayan a pecar.
So that you will not sin.
Quiero honrar al pastor de esta casa.
I want to honor the pastor of this house.
Quiero honrar la primera dama.
And the first lady of this house.
Y agradecer la invitación que nos has extendido.
And appreciate this invitation that you allowed us today.
Me alegro poder escuchar.
I rejoice to be able to hear.
Nombres de pastores y ministros que están presentes.
Names of pastors and ministers that are present today.
Gracias.
Thank you.
Por acompañarnos en esta
for
noche.
For being with us tonight.
Que sus vidas sean bendecidas.
May your lives be blessed.
Aún más allá de lo que usted espera.
More than what you could even imagine.
Oh. Y congregación de West Toronto.
And to the congregation of West Toronto.
Woo! 52 años.
52 years.
Es una vida completa.
That's a whole lifetime.
Yo me siento bien contentísimo.
I feel very happy at this moment.
De poder compartir este altar.
To be able to share this altar.
Y este momento con mi amada esposa.
And this moment with my loving wife, who's so beautiful. And powerful in her own right. That's called discernment.
That's not translation, that's interpretation. There's a difference. Hay una diferencia entre interpretación y traducir. Big difference. But I agree.
God is good.
God has blessed us. Dios nos ha bendecido. 37 años de matrimonio.
37 years of marital bliss.
Y Dios,
and God
tiene una corona bien grande para ella en el cielo.
Has a big gigantic crown for her in heaven.
Por tolerarme a mí por 37 años.
For tolerating me for 37 years. You're all right, I'll keep you.
Amen. I'm good for another 37. Praise the Lord. Man, what an amazing atmosphere.
Qué atmósfera tan linda en esta noche.
And I'll continue all the protocol tomorrow night.
Continuamos con los protocolos mañana.
I don't want to miss this moment.
Pero yo no quiero perder este momento.
I believe we've been set up.
Yo creo que nosotros, el Señor tiene algo grande para nosotros en esta noche.
We have been set up. If you thought you was coming to another service,
si tú creíste que iba a llegar para un culto como antes,
you've been set up.
Están equivocados.
I want to take you, quiero llevarles a la porción bíblica.
I want to take you to the portion of scripture.
Es la carta a la iglesia de Gálatas.
And it's the letter to the church in Galatians.
Capítulo 6.
Chapter 6.
Y el versículo 14.
And verse 14.
Que Dios bendiga su palabra.
May the Lord bless his word.
Y así dice Pablo al pueblo, a los Gálatas.
And this is what Paul says to the people of Galatia.
Pero lejos esté de mí gloriarme, sino en la cruz de nuestro Señor Jesucristo, por quien el mundo ha sido crucificado para mí y yo para el mundo.
Galatians chapter 6 and verse 14 says, "But God forbid that I should glory or boast save in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom the world is crucified unto me and I unto the world."
Quiero hablarles en este día.
I want to talk to you today.
Y he luchado para poder establecer un título de este mensaje.
And I've been battling to find a title for this message.
Uno de ellos que pensé,
one of the ones that came to mind,
me gloriaré en la cruz.
I will glory in the cross.
La otra,
and the other was,
tengo que visitar el Calvario.
I've got to visit Calvary.
Tome usted el tema que quiera.
You pick the one you want.
Pero yo voy a predicar lo que Dios me ha dado.
But I'm going to preach what God gave me.
¿Cuántos están de acuerdo?
How many of you are in agreement? Amen.
Denle una vez más un fuerte ofrenda al Señor.
Just give God one more offering of praise before you take your seats.
Come on, church. Give him a good one. Don't be cheap with your offering. Come on.
Adora a Dios.
No sea mezquino con tu ofrenda. Si pueden, tomen sus asientos.
If you can, take your seats.
Pablo tenía mucho de lo que podría haberse jactado.
Paul had a lot in which that he could have boasted.
Fue él.
It was he.
Más grande predicador de la iglesia.
The greatest preacher of the church.
El más grande misionero.
The greatest missionary.
El más grande teólogo.
The greatest theologian.
Él escribió más libros.
He wrote more books.
Que nadie en la Biblia.
Than anyone else in the Bible.
Casi la mitad del Nuevo Testamento.
Almost half of the New Testament belongs to him.
Pablo.
Paul.
Era un judío de pura cepa.
He was a full-fledged Jew.
Pertenecía a la tribu de Benjamín.
He belonged to the tribe of Benjamin.
Había sido seleccionado como fariseo.
He was chosen as a Pharisee.
Era, para decirlo sin rodeos, un gran engranaje en la sinagoga. Without twisting it, without giving it too many circles, he was a big shot in the synagogue.
We planned that.
My beautiful wife, for those who don't know her yet. Sin embargo,
nevertheless,
Pablo dijo,
Paul said,
me glorío,
I will glory,
me jacto,
I will boast,
de una cosa,
of one thing,
la cruz,
the cross,
de nuestro Señor Jesucristo,
of our Lord Jesus Christ,
y no solo la cruz,
and not only the cross,
otra vez,
again.
Es la cruz.
It's the cross
de nuestro Señor Jesucristo.
Of our Lord Jesus Christ.
El orgullo de Pablo.
The pride of Paul.
Era la cruz de Cristo.
Was the cross of Jesus.
La predicación de Pablo.
The preaching of Paul.
Fue la cruz de Cristo.
Was the cross of Jesus.
La alabanza de Pablo.
The praise of Paul.
Se enfocó en la cruz de Cristo.
Was focused on the cross of Christ.
En los días de Pablo.
In the days of Paul.
La cruz era nada.
The cross
was nothing de lo que jactarse.
That you should take pride or be boastful for.
Maldito todo el que sea cruel de un madero. Cursed be that which is the cross. Era un instrumento de muerte.
It was an instrument of death.
La crucifixión.
The crucifixion.
En una cruz.
On a cross.
Fue una de las formas más crueles.
It was one of the cruelest ways.
De ejecución.
To execute.
Jamás concebidos por el hombre.
That would ever be conceived of man.
Hoy hemos convertido la cruz.
Today we've converted the cross.
En una pieza de joyería.
Into a piece of jewelry.
Una joyería de oro.
A jewelry of gold.
Que llevamos colgado del cuello.
That we carry around our necks.
Mencionas la cruz.
We mention the cross.
Hoy piensas en un joyero.
Or you think about
a jeweler. Pero si mencionas la cruz,
but if you mention the cross,
en los días de Pablo,
in the days of Paul,
era un instrumento de muerte.
It was an instrument of death.
En los púlpitos modernos,
in the modern pulpits,
en todo el mundo,
and in all the world,
se dice que el problema del hombre,
it is said that the problem with man,
es falta de autoestima,
is that they have a lack of self-esteem,
y lo que necesita,
and what they need,
es pensamiento positivo,
is positive thinking,
o el problema del hombre,
or the problem with man,
es ignorancia,
is ignorance,
y lo que necesita,
and what they need,
es más educación,
is more education,
o el problema del hombre,
or the problem with man
es la pobreza,
is poverty.
Y lo que necesita es dinero,
and what they need is more money.
El problema del hombre,
the problem with man
es el medio ambiente,
it's the mediocrity.
Y lo que necesita,
and what they need
es igualdad de oportunidades,
is to have equal opportunity.
La Biblia dice,
the Bible says,
a pesar lo que dice el mundo,
besides what the world says,
la Biblia dice,
the Bible says,
que el problema del hombre,
that the problem with man,
es el pecado,
is sin.
Y lo que necesita,
and what they need,
es la cruz,
is the cross.
Lo voy a decir de nuevo.
I'm going to say it again.
El problema del hombre,
the problem with man,
no se va a resolver,
is not going to be resolved,
con educación,
with education,
con dinero,
with money,
o con oportunidades,
or with opportunity.
El problema del hombre,
the problem with man,
que es el pecado,
that is sin,
será resolvido,
will be resolved,
con la cruz,
with the cross,
y no cualquier cruz,
and not just any cross.
Es la cruz de nuestro Salvador.
It's the cross of our Savior.
Es la cruz de nuestro Redentor.
The cross of our Redeemer.
Es la cruz de Jesucristo.
The cross of Jesus Christ.
Por lo tanto,
so therefore,
necesitamos,
we need,
que la predicación de la cruz,
that the preaching of the cross,
regrese,
return,
a los púlpitos de nuestro santuario,
to the pulpits and in our sanctuaries.
Yo estoy harto ya.
I'm already tired.
Y me imagino que también el Señor,
and I can imagine that the Lord also,
luego de dejar su trono,
after leaving his throne,
caminar por esta tierra,
to walk on this earth,
sufrir lo que sufrió,
suffered what he suffered,
sacrificar su cuerpo,
sacrificed his body,
sacrificar su posición,
sacrificed his position,
y que ahora la iglesia,
and now the church,
de predicar de la cruz.
Ceases to preach about the cross.
Este es el tiempo.
This is the time.
De regresar a nuestros púlpitos.
To return to our pulpits.
Con un mensaje asertivo.
With an effective message.
De la cruz.
Of the cross.
Si no hubiera sido por la cruz.
Because if it had not been for the cross.
Usted y yo no estuviéramos aquí.
You and I would not be here today.
Bueno, no me voy a adelantar.
I don't want to get ahead of myself.
Primera de Corintios 1:18.
1 Corinthians 1:18 says.
Porque la predicación de la cruz,
because the preaching of the cross,
es locura para los que se pierden,
is craziness for those that are lost.
Pero para nosotros,
but for us,
lo que somos salvos,
who are saved,
es poder de Dios.
Is power of God. My God.
Háblale a tu vecino que no es creyente de la cruz.
Talk to your friend or your neighbor about the cross who's not a believer.
Y va a pensar que es locura.
And he's going to think, this is craziness.
Va a decir, qué necio.
He said, you're crazy, you're a fool.
¿Cómo tú vas a creer en esto?
How could you believe this stuff?
Habla de los acontecimientos.
Talk to them about everything that happened.
Y piensa que Jesús fue un masoquista.
And they'll start to believe that, man, maybe Christ was a masochist.
Habla de todo lo que ocurrió.
Talk to them about everything that happened.
Y piensa que Jesús estaba ciego.
And they would believe that maybe God was blind.
Un Jesús que podía entender los pensamientos.
A Jesus who can understand the mindset.
Leer los pensamientos de sus discípulos.
Who could read the thoughts of his disciples.
Como él no pudo entender.
How could he have not known?
Y a entender huir.
Or understood and understanding have not fled.
De lo que venía.
Of what was to come.
Es que Jesús entendía.
It's that Jesus understood.
Woo! Que para nosotros.
That for us.
La cruz.
The cross.
Es poder.
Is power. Yes, sir.
Sí, como Pablo, necesitamos gloriarnos en la cruz.
And just like Paul, we need to glory in the cross.
Necesitamos predicar la cruz.
We need to preach the cross.
Debemos de gloriarnos en la persona de la cruz.
We should glory in the person of the cross.
No es la cruz.
It's not the cross.
Que hace especial a Cristo.
That makes Jesus special.
Es Cristo.
It's Christ.
Quien hace especial a la cruz.
Who makes the cross special.
Hay gente que adora la cruz.
There are people that will worship the cross.
Y se olvidan de la persona de Cristo.
And they forget about the person of Christ.
Okay, no tengo tiempo para hablar de eso.
I don't have time to dive into that part.
Porque, bueno, no, I'm not going to do it.
Because I just
un día.
One day.
Un profesor cristiano.
A Christian professor
estaba dando una conferencia.
Was giving a conference.
En una universidad.
In a university.
Una universidad cristiana.
A Christian university.
Y un joven judío.
And a Jewish young man.
Que estaba estudiando allí.
That was studying there.
Le preguntó al maestro.
Asked the master.
Al profesor.
The teacher. The professor.
¿Qué tiene de grandioso Jesucristo?
Why? What is so great about this Jesus?
Oh, goodness. ¿Qué hizo Jesucristo que fue tan especial?
What did Jesus Christ do that was so special?
El profesor respondió de la siguiente manera.
And the professor responded in this way.
Supongo que sabes mucho sobre la historia.
I suppose you know a lot about this story.
La historia de los judíos.
The story of the Jews.
Como buen judío, tú conoces la historia.
And as a good Jew, you know the story.
Y tú debes de entender.
So you must understand.
La experiencia que tuvo los judíos.
The experience that the Jewish people had.
Con personas de autoridad.
With people of authority.
Como Herodes.
Like Herod.
Como Pilato.
As Pilate.
Y los antiguos emperadores.
And all the emperors of the olden age.
Que crucificaron.
That crucified.
En un promedio de tiempo corto.
In a small amount of time.
30,000 crucifixiones.
30,000 crucifixions.
Y la mayoría.
And the majority.
Jóvenes judíos.
Were young Jewish people.
Es más, si recuerdo bien la historia.
And as a matter of fact, if I remember well the story.
Que entre todos los que se habían crucificado.
In the midst of all of those that were crucified.
Había más de 30,000.
There was more than 30,000.
Pero hubo un censo.
But there was a census.
Que identificó un mínimo de 30,000 jóvenes adultos.
That identified a minimum of 30,000 young Jewish people.
El joven dijo.
And this young man said.
Tiene razón.
You have all the reasoning.
Tú estás correcto.
You're right.
El profesor entonces le preguntó.
So then the professor asked him.
Bueno.
Well.
Voy a nombrar uno de esos judíos.
I'm going to name one of those Jewish people.
Y tú nombras a otro.
And then you name another.
¿Estamos de acuerdo?
Okay, we're in agreement.
Yo de los 30,000 yo voy a nombrar uno.
So from the 30,000 that were crucified, I'm going to name one.
Y le voy a dar la oportunidad.
And then I'm going to give you the opportunity.
Para que tú dé el nombre de otro.
For you to name another.
Y él dijo.
And he said.
Yo nombro a Jesucristo.
The professor said, I name Jesus Christ.
Ahora, nombra tú.
And now, give me your name.
Solo un nombre.
Only one.
No diez.
I don't need 10.
No cinco.
I don't need 5.
Ni dos.
Not even 2.
Dame el nombre de uno más.
Just give me one more.
Que fue crucificado.
That was crucified.
Uno.
One.
Entre 29,999.
Within 29,999.
Que tú puedas nombrar.
That you could name.
Que fue crucificado.
That was also crucified.
Bueno, dijo el estudiante.
Well, the student said.
No sé.
I don't know.
No tengo otro nombre.
I don't have another name.
Y el profesor,
and the professor
dice,
said,
¿sabes por qué no podía, no puede mencionar otro nombre?
You know why you can't say another name?
¿No lo sabes?
Why you don't know one?
¿Por qué recordamos un nombre?
Why we only remember one name?
¿Y no podemos recordar otro?
And we can't remember any other?
Entre 29,999.
Among 29,999.
Porque Jesús.
It's because Jesus.
Es el único.
Is the only one.
Que murió.
That died.
Por nuestros pecados.
For our sins.
Y resucitó.
And resurrected.
Entre los muertos.
With among the dead.
Fue Jesús.
It was Jesus
que convirtió la cruz
that turned the cross
de un símbolo de culpa
from a symbol of guilt
en un símbolo de gloria
to a symbol of glory
de un rayo de ejecución
into a ray of execution
de un bálsamo de salvación
to a balsam of salvation.
No es la cruz lo que es tan maravillosa.
It's not the cross that's so marvelous.
Es Cristo en la cruz.
It's Jesus Christ on the cross.
Lo que es tan maravilloso.
That is marvelous.
Jesús conocía
Jesus knew
la forma de su muerte.
The form of his death.
Sabía
he knew
que sería
that he would be crucified.
Conocía
he knew
el motivo de su muerte.
The motive for his death.
Pero no hay problema.
But that's not the
porque
problem.
Cuando él dejó su trono,
because when he left his throne,
él tomó la decisión,
he made the decision.
Yo voy a morir.
He said, I'm going to die.
Yo voy a morir.
I'm going to die.
Yo tengo que morir.
I've got to die.
Tengo que entregarme.
I've got to give myself.
Para que tú y yo
so that you and I
seamos escapes de la muerte.
Could escape death. Woo.
Él vino a morir.
He came to die.
Uno de los mensajes más poderosos que yo he escuchado.
And one of the greatest messages that I've heard.
De Navidad.
Of around the Christmas.
Es que él nació.
Is that he was born.
Para morir.
To die.
Yo tengo tres hijos.
I've got 3 children.
Tenemos tres hijos.
We have 3 children.
Yo nunca.
I would never.
Corrígeme si estoy equivocado.
And correct me if I'm wrong.
Nunca.
Never.
A nacer nuestros hijos.
Even to the birthing of our children.
Nunca hablamos.
We've never spoke.
De planes.
Of plans.
De cómo ellos iban a morir.
Of how they were going to die.
Nunca decidimos.
We never decided.
Que eventualmente iban a morir.
That eventually they would die.
Cuando tú y yo hablamos.
When you and I spoke.
Hablamos de vida.
We spoke about life.
Hablamos de prosperidad.
We spoke about prosperity.
Hablamos de avanzar en la vida.
We spoke about advancing in their lives.
Miramos a nuestros hijos.
We looked at our children.
Como grandes líderes.
As they were great leaders.
Tremendos ministros.
Tremendous ministers.
Tremendos adoradores.
Great worshipers.
Pero nunca.
But never.
Hablamos de muerte.
Did we speak of death?
Sin embargo.
Oh, but.
El ángel.
The angel.
Se acerca a la mujer.
Comes close to the woman.
Y le dice a la mujer.
And he tells the woman.
Van a ser un hijo.
Your son is going to be
y lo
born.
Llamará Emmanuel.
And his name will be Emmanuel.
Y le dijo al papá.
And he told his father,
no corra,
don't run,
no temas,
don't fear,
porque van a ser un hijo,
because you're going to have a
y
son,
no tiene nada que ver,
and you ain't got nothing to do
pero
with
el que van a ser,
it, but the one that will be
viene
born
para morir,
is coming to die,
viene para morir,
is coming to die.
La cruz.
The cross.
Simplemente.
Simply.
Fue el punto geográfico.
Was the geographic point.
De donde se iba a cumplir.
Of where it would be fulfilled.
La promesa del Padre.
Where the promise of the Father
Él
would be fulfilled.
Viene para morir.
He is coming to die.
Jesús conocía su motivo de muerte.
Jesus knew the motive for his death.
Él conocía el momento de su muerte.
He knew the moment of his death.
No murió, sin embargo, no murió.
He didn't die.
Hasta que dijo.
Until he said.
Padre.
Lord. Father.
En tus manos.
Into your hands.
Encomiendo mi espíritu.
I commend my spirit. Come on.
Hay una verdad que no podemos olvidar.
There's a truth that we cannot forget.
Nadie lo mató.
Nobody killed him.
Fue crucificado.
He was crucified.
Pero nadie lo mató.
But nobody killed him.
Él dijo,
he said,
Padre,
Father,
en tus manos.
I give it into your hands.
En tus manos.
I give it into your hands.
En tus manos.
I give it into your hands.
Esto no se termina.
This does not end.
Hasta que yo entregue tus
until
manos.
I give it into your hands.
Mi espíritu.
My spirit. Jesus.
Mira mis hermanos.
Listen.
Sin la cruz.
Without the cross.
Nunca sabríamos.
We would have never known.
Lo que significa ser salvos.
What being saved would be.
Y ser libres.
And to be free.
De la pena del pecado.
From the guilt of sin.
De ser libres del poder.
To be free from the power.
El poder del pecado.
The power of sin.
Y un día Jesús.
And one day Jesus.
Vendrá.
Will come.
Oh, yo quiero decirlo otra vez.
And I want to tell you that again.
Él viene otra vez.
He's coming again.
Oh, él viene otra vez.
He's coming again.
Él viene otra
He's
vez.
He's coming again.
La primera vez que vino.
The first time he came.
Nos libró del pecado.
He freed us from sin.
De nuestras propias vidas.
From our own lives.
Pero la segunda vez que venga.
But the second time he
nos
comes.
Va a librar.
He's going to free us.
Del ambiente pecaminoso.
From the atmosphere of sin.
Porque cuando suena la trompeta.
Because when the trumpet sounds.
Yo dije que cuando suena la trompeta.
When the trumpet sounds,
sonarán,
they will sound
para que tú y yo escuchemos,
so you and I can hear it.
El llamado del Padre,
the call of the Father,
sacándonos de esta tierra,
taking us from this land.
Koyama se anda katamaso.
Come on, yes, Lord.
Iglesia,
church.
Pueden entender.
Can you understand
que toda la confesión,
that all confession,
el arrepentimiento,
repentance,
la fe,
faith,
las lágrimas,
tears,
y el remordimiento, and the remorse que humanamente podrías reunir,
that humanly we can pull together,
serían absolutamente inútiles,
would be absolutely worthless.
Sin la cruz del Señor Jesús.
Without the cross of Jesus Christ.
No hay manera de salir del infierno.
There's no other way to get out from hell.
No hay otra manera.
There's no other way to evade hell.
De salir del infierno.
To come out of hell.
Y tampoco no hay otra manera.
And nor is there another way.
De entrar al cielo.
To go into heaven.
Acepto a través de la cruz.
Except by the cross.
So número uno, debemos de gloriarnos en la cruz.
So number one, we've got to glory in the cross.
¿Cuántos están dispuestos a gloriarse?
How many of you are just willing to glory?
En la persona de la cruz.
In the person of the cross.
En la persona de la cruz.
In the person of the cross.
Debemos gloriarnos.
We should glory.
En el propósito de la cruz.
In the purpose of the cross.
A través de la cruz,
through the cross,
se expresa el amor de Dios.
The love of God is expressed.
Yo aprecio mucho mi experiencia en el seminario.
I appreciate very much my experience in seminary.
Pero una clase de hermenéutica.
But there was a hermeneutic class.
En mi clase de doctorado ministerial.
In my doctoral, ministerial doctoral class.
El profesor dijo.
The professor said.
La primera tarde.
The first afternoon,
la primera reunión,
our first meeting,
él dijo,
he said,
hay que escribir lo siguiente.
You've got to write down the following.
Le voy a dar la clave.
I'm going to give you the key.
La clave.
The key.
De todos sus estudios teológicos.
To all of the theological studies you'll have.
Que también será la clave.
That will also be the key.
De tu vida.
For your life.
En relación con Dios.
In relation to God.
Sacamos nuestros cuadernos.
So we all took out our notebooks.
Prendimos, encendimos nuestros dispositivos.
We opened up our iPads and everything else we had.
Y que ya estábamos en la espera.
And we were ready waiting.
Esta es la clave.
This is the key.
Si no es, si perdemos la clave.
If we lose this moment and the key.
Vamos a perder el momento.
If we lose this key, this moment, we're going to miss the moment.
Cuando él vio que estábamos listos.
When he saw,
when
that,
he saw
that we were ready,
él dijo,
he said,
ponga atención.
I want you to listen closely.
Dios,
God
es,
is
amor.
Love.
Nosotros como buenos estudiantes,
and we as good students,
estábamos esperando la clave.
We were waiting for him to give us the key.
Porque eso lo aprendimos en la escuela dominical.
Because we learned that in Sunday school.
Yo lo aprendí a la edad de 4 años.
I learned that at the age of 4.
Yo estoy esperando algo profundo.
I'm waiting for him to get profound with me.
Que vaya a entrar a profundidad.
That he takes me deep into it.
Algo que yo nunca he escuchado.
Something that I've never heard before.
Y cuando él vio,
and when he saw,
que nadie estaba escribiendo,
that nobody was writing,
él dijo,
he said,
en un enojo santo,
in one of his angry,
holy anger,
in holy anger,
¿por qué no están escribiendo?
Why isn't anybody writing?
La clave es,
the key is,
Dios,
God,
se detuvo,
and he waited,
para que pudiéramos escribir esa palabra,
so that
nombre,
we could start writing. He could see us writing.
Es,
is,
amor,
love.
Hay gente que todavía están esperando.
There are people that are still waiting.
Una revelación.
For a revelation.
Una revelación única.
A one and only revelation.
Se encierran en sus casas.
A unique revelation, and they close themselves in their house.
Botan a los hijos de la casa.
They throw their kids out.
Botan a su cónyuge de la
they
casa.
They tell their spouse to leave.
Dicen que nadie me puede llamar.
They say no one can call me.
Apagan sus teléfonos.
They turn off their phones.
Todos son medios de comunicación.
And all of their other ways
porque
of communication.
Porque hay una revelación nueva.
Because there's a revelation.
Hay algo profundo.
There's a deepness coming.
Que va a cambiar todo.
That's going to change everything.
Y hace años atrás.
And it was years ago.
Que se fundó la revelación más grande.
That this revelation was founded.
Y la revelación es.
And that revelation is.
Que Dios.
That God.
Es.
Is.
Amor.
Love.
Si yo lo dejo ahí esta noche,
and if I leave that here right now,
usted debe de irse contento,
you should all go happy,
que Dios es amor,
that God is love,
porque yo y usted,
because you and I,
no merecemos el amor de Dios,
don't deserve his love,
si no hubiera sido por el amor de Dios,
but had it not been for the love of God,
mi alma,
my soul,
hubiera estado perdido,
would have been lost,
si no hubiera sido por el amor de Dios,
had it not been for the love of God,
tuviera yo,
I would be
nadando en el fango,
I'm walking in dirt.
Swimming in the mud, nadando en fango.
Swimming in the mud,
buscando la manera de salir.
Looking for a way out,
debilitando mis recursos.
Wasting my resources,
porque no entiendo.
Because I don't understand.
Que si solo puedo yo conocer.
That if only I would understand.
Esa profundidad.
The profoundness of this right here.
Eso cambia todo.
That would change
cuando
everything.
Cuando yo entiendo.
When I understand.
Que Dios es amor.
That God is love.
Mi hogar cambia.
My house changes.
Cuando yo entiendo,
when I understand,
que Dios es amor,
that God is love,
mi comunidad cambia.
My community changes.
Cuando yo vivo,
when I live,
expresando,
expressing,
con mi vida,
with my life,
con mi estilo de vida,
with my lifestyle,
que Dios es amor,
that God is love,
se salvarán los perdidos.
Then those that are lost could be saved.
Seré atractivo. I will be attractive to those who don't know God.
Para aquellos que no conocen a Dios.
But that's not deep enough for some of us.
Pero eso no es demasiado de profundo para algunos de nosotros.
Romanos 5:8.
Romans 5:8.
Pero Dios muestra su amor.
But God shows his love.
Para con nosotros.
With us, towards us.
En que siendo aún pecadores.
In that while we were still sinners. My God.
Yo trato de decirle a alguno de mis amigos.
I try to tell some of my friends.
Lo invito a la iglesia.
I invite them to church.
Le hablo de Cristo.
I talk to them about Christ.
Es más, a mi familia.
As a matter of fact, let me even go further. My family.
Yo tengo un tío.
I have an uncle.
Yo soy mayor que él.
I'm older than him.
Lo llevo por 4 meses.
I'm older by 4 months.
Y yo le digo a él.
And I always tell him.
Samuel.
Sam.
Tú tienes que regresar.
You've got to come home.
Tú sabes que Dios te ama.
You know that God loves you.
Tú sabes que Dios te ha librado de la mucha.
You know that God has taken you from
a lot. Y la respuesta de él.
And his answer is.
Si yo lo sé.
Yeah, I know it.
Pero voy a arreglar algunas cosas
primero.
But I
gotta fix some things first.
¿Qué dijo Pablo?
And what does Paul say here?
Muestra su amor para nosotros.
He demonstrates his love for us.
En que siendo aún pecadores.
While we were still yet sinners.
Él no está esperando que tú arregles tu vida.
He's not waiting for you to fix your life.
Porque hay muchos que hace 30 años que comenzaron y todavía no lo han logrado.
Because there are many that have been 30 years in this thing and they still haven't fixed things.
Thirty years
doing the same thing.
Repitiendo los mismos errores.
Repeating the same errors.
30 años huyendo.
30 years running.
30 años evitando.
30 years evading.
Y siguen igual. And they continue as always. Pero Pablo dice,
but then Paul says,
aún siendo pecadores,
while we were yet sinners,
él nos amó.
He loved us.
1
John chapter 4 and verse 10 says,
en esto consiste,
in this is love.
El amor, no en que nosotros hayamos amado a Dios,
not that we loved God,
sino en que Él nos amó a nosotros,
but that He loved us.
I'm sorry if this is too simple for us today.
Perdóname si esto es demasiado de simple para nosotros en esta noche.
I came all the way from Allentown, Pennsylvania.
Yo vine desde Allentown, Pennsylvania.
To tell you something you already knew.
Para decirte algo que ya ustedes sabían.
But just maybe.
Pero por lo mejor.
Quizás lo han ignorado.
You've ignored it.
Una niñita que acababa de empezar la escuela.
I have a story of a little girl who just began school.
Está en la iglesia con su mamá.
She was in church with her mom.
Y vio la cruz.
And she saw the cross.
Y le dijo a su mami.
And she told her mom.
Mamá.
Mami.
¿Por qué está ahí ese signo de más?
She said, Mom, why is that
plus sign
there?
Apenas comenzó la clase.
She just started school.
Y cuando vio.
And when she saw.
Lo que ella vio fue el insignio de más.
When she saw the cross, what she saw was just a plus sign.
La mamá le respondió.
And her mother responded to her.
Bueno, acertó. She asserted, yeah, that's good. La cruz.
The cross.
Es la señal.
Is the sign.
La señal más de Dios.
Of more of God.
It is the plus sign of God.
Es la señal que Dios es más.
Que nos dice a ti y a mí.
That tells you and me.
Que él está con nosotros.
That he is with us.
Que él nos ama.
That he loves us.
Que nos amó tanto.
That he loved us so much.
Que envió a su hijo a morir.
That he gave his son to die.
Por nosotros.
For us.
Para que pudiéramos ser salvos.
So that we could be saved.
Alguien ha dicho.
Someone said.
Que fue en la cruz.
That it was on the cross.
Donde el hombre hizo lo peor a Dios.
Where man did his worst to God.
Pero Dios hizo lo mejor que pudo por el hombre.
But God did the best he could for man.
Es el lugar.
It's the place.
A través de la cruz.
By the cross.
Que se satisface la ley de Dios.
That the law of God is satisfied.
Ezequiel 18:20 dice.
Ezekiel 28
1820 says, el alma que pecare morirá.
1820 says, the soul that sins will die.
Romanos 3:23 dice,
Romans 3:23 says,
la paga del pecado,
that the wages of sin
es muerte,
is death.
En otras palabras,
in other words,
todos tienen,
either all must die,
que morir por sus pecados,
for their sins,
o alguien tiene que morir,
or someone must die,
por los pecados de todos,
for the sins of all.
O todos tienen que morir por sus pecados.
Or either everyone must die for their sins.
O alguien tiene que morir por todos los pecados.
Or someone must die for all of their sins.
Y ahí es donde entra Cristo.
And here's where Jesus Christ enters
entra.
On the cross.
Cuando Jesucristo murió en esa cruz.
When he died on the cross.
No solo murió para pagar por nuestros pecados.
He not only died to pay for our sins.
Sino murió para cumplir la ley de Dios.
But he died to fulfill the law of God.
Algo, alguien tuvo que morir.
Someone had to die.
Tenía una deuda.
There was a debt.
Que no podía pagar.
I could not pay.
Pero él pagó una deuda.
But he paid a debt.
Que no tenía.
That he didn't have. My God.
Yo voy a seguir.
I'm going to move forward.
Tercer punto.
The third point.
Debemos gloriarnos en el poder de la cruz.
We are to glory in the power of the cross.
Antes que Jesús muriera en la cruz.
Before Jesus died on the cross.
Esa cruz era un símbolo de vergüenza.
That cross was a symbol of shame.
Debilidad.
Weakness.
Y derrota.
And defeat.
Pero desde que nuestro Señor y Salvador Jesucristo murió.
Ever since our Lord Jesus Christ died.
Esa cruz.
That cross.
Salió victorioso.
Was a symbol of victory.
Salió victorioso de entre los muertos.
Became victorious within the dead,
esa,
among the dead.
Esa cruz ha sido un símbolo.
And that cross has become a symbol
de gloria,
of glory,
poder,
power,
y victoria,
and victory.
Mira, mis hermanos,
look, my brethren.
Nosotros tenemos tres enemigos.
We've got three enemies.
El enemigo número uno.
Number one.
Es interno.
Is an internal.
Se
enemy.
Llama la carne.
And that's called your flesh.
Pablo habló de esto.
Paul speaks of this.
La lucha entre el espíritu y la carne.
It's the battle between your flesh and your spirit.
Cuando la lucha entre los ambos.
And when there's a battle between the two.
Que causa crisis.
It causes crisis.
A veces no sabemos dónde estamos.
And sometimes we don't know where we are.
Ese es el primer enemigo.
So that's our first enemy.
El enemigo interno.
It's an internal enemy.
Llamado la carne.
And it's called your flesh.
Hay el enemigo externo.
And now there's an external enemy.
Llamado el mundo.
And that's called the world.
Oh, yo sé.
I know.
La influencia de este mundo.
The influence of this world.
Es bastante fuerte.
Is very strong.
Pero no debe de poder más.
But it cannot have more power than the influence
de la reflexión
or the reflection
del cuerpo de Jesucristo,
of the body of Jesus
que
Christ
se llama iglesia.
That is called church.
Y el tercer enemigo infernal.
And our third enemy
es infernal.
Is the infernal enemy.
Llamado diablo.
And that's called the devil.
Y no voy a usar su nombre mucho esta noche.
And I'm not going to use his name too much tonight.
Yo no quiero glorificar al diablo.
Because I'm not trying to glorify him.
Lo voy a dar la identidad que merece.
I'm going to give him the identity that he deserves.
Derrotado.
Defeated.
Yo dije derrotado.
I said defeated.
Yo dije derrotado.
I said defeated.
Yo dije...
I said,
derrotado.
Defeated.
Somebody's going to get it.
Alguien más
yo dije,
I said,
que la identidad del diablo,
that the identity of the enemy,
es que está,
is that he is,
derrotado.
Defeated.
Él está,
he is,
derrotado.
Defeated.
Él está,
he is,
derrotado.
Defeated.
El único victorioso.
The only one that's victorious.
Se llama Jesucristo.
His name is Jesus.
Y si él con nosotros.
And if he is with us.
¿Quién contra nosotros?
Who could be against us?
Oh, vamos a seguir. El enemigo infernal es el diablo.
The infernal enemy is the devil.
Pero a través de la cruz,
but through the cross
del Señor Jesucristo,
of the Lord Jesus Christ,
tenemos victoria.
We have victory over
no
all.
Solo sobre uno.
Not only one.
No solo sobre dos.
Not only victory over two.
Sino sobre los tres.
But victory over
victoria
all three.
Victoria sobre la carne.
We have victory over our
victoria
carnal
sobre
self.
Sobre el mundo.
Over the world.
Victoria sobre el diablo.
And over the enemy.
A través de la cruz.
Through the cross.
Hay victoria.
We have victory.
Podemos clavar.
We could cry out.
Clavar.
We could nail.
La lujuria de la carne en la cruz.
The lust of the flesh to the cross.
A través de la cruz.
Because by the cross,
tenemos la victoria sobre el mundo.
Through the cross, we have victory over the world.
Mira, escucha atentamente.
Listen very carefully.
No solo tenemos salvación a través de la cruz.
Not only do we have salvation through the cross,
sino tenemos santificación.
But we have sanctification through
a través
the cross.
De la cruz. By the means of the cross. Conocemos que tenemos salvación.
We know we have salvation.
Pero muchos.
But many.
Devalorizan, they devalue,
devaluate, devalue
la cruz, el poder de la cruz,
the power of the cross,
cuando no viven en santidad,
when they're not living a sanctified life.
Se quejan de los que no quieren dar su vida a Cristo.
They complain about those that don't want to give their life to Christ.
Pero siguen viviendo su vida.
But they keep living their own life.
Sin santidad.
Without sanctification.
Without holiness.
Without holiness. That's a good word right there.
Santificaos, dice la palabra.
Be holy, the word says. Come on now.
Santificaos.
Be holy.
Porque yo soy santo.
Because I am holy.
Uno de los versículos que me daba mucho temor como niño.
One of the verses that gave me fear when I was a child.
Sin santidad.
Was without holiness.
Nadie.
Nobody. No one.
Aquí no le estamos hablando a los que están condenados por sus pecados.
We're not talking to those who are condemned for their sins. That's not who we're talking to right now.
Estamos hablando a aquellos.
We are talking now to those
que llegaron a la cruz.
That can't got to the cross.
Se arrepienten en el momento por su pecado.
Repented in that moment for their sins.
Pero en vez de depositar sus pecados,
but instead of depositing and leaving their sins,
se ponen la mochila de pecado y siguen caminando.
They put on the backpack of their sin and they keep walking.
Sin santidad.
Without holiness.
Pastor, I thought it was impossible to live as holy as the word was asking.
Yo siempre creía que era imposible vivir la vida de santidad como nos dice la palabra.
¿Cómo es posible?
How is that possible?
Vivir en santidad.
To live in holiness.
Visitando la cruz.
Visiting the cross.
Y manteniéndome debajo de esa fuente inagotable.
And maintaining myself under that fountain
that never,
that
runs
never dries up.
God Almighty. Tenemos poder para ser santificados a través de la cruz.
We have power to be made holy through the cross.
Jesús no solo murió.
Jesus didn't only die.
Para que pudiéramos vivir felices en el cielo.
So that we could live a happy life in heaven.
Él murió.
He died.
Para que pudiéramos vivir santos en la tierra.
So that we could live holy on this land.
Jesús murió.
Jesus died.
Para liberarnos.
To free us.
Del cristianismo mundano.
From the worldly Christianity.
Bien se podría hablar de un diablo celestial. We can speak about a heavenly devil. Wow. Si pudiéramos hablar de un cristiano mundano. If we can talk about a worldly Christian. La única manera.
The only way.
Que podemos hablar.
That we can talk.
De un cristianismo mundano.
Of a worldly Christianity.
Es si hay un diablo celestial.
Is that we are saying that there is a celestial
devil.
Devil. I can't even say that. My God.
Pablo dice,
Paul says
que a través de la cruz,
that by the cross, through the cross,
el mundo me ha sido crucificado.
The world has been crucified to me.
¿Alguna vez te has parado a pensar?
Have you ever stopped to think?
En lo que este mundo le hizo a Jesús.
What this world did to Jesus?
Lo crucificó.
They crucified him.
Es por eso que necesitamos crucificar al mundo.
And that's why we need to crucify the world.
Necesitas entender.
We've got to understand.
Que como hijos de Dios.
That as a child of God.
El mundo no tiene nada que ofrecerte.
The world has nothing to offer you.
La crucifixión.
The crucifixion.
Es una forma de muerte.
It's one form of death.
Que no puede.
That you cannot inflict.
Infligirte a ti mismo.
Inflict upon yourself.
Es decir.
It's to say.
Puedes dispararte.
You can shoot yourself.
Puedes ahogarte.
You can drown yourself.
Puedes ahogarte.
You can hang yourself.
Puede apuñalarte,
you can stab yourself,
pero no puedes crucificarte.
But you cannot crucify yourself.
La crucifixión es algo.
Crucifixion is something.
A lo que debes rendirte.
You must surrender to.
Todos los días.
Every day.
Si te rindes de nuevo a la cruz,
if you
Señor,
surrender once more to the cross,
y tomas la muerte para ti mismo,
and you take death for yourself,
encontrarás la victoria en cualquier situación.
You'll find victory in every situation.
A través de la cruz,
by the cross,
tenemos la victoria sobre el diablo.
We have victory over the enemy.
Desde el Calvario,
from Calvary,
el diablo ha sido un enemigo derrotado.
The devil has already been a defeated enemy.
Navegando un barco que se hunde.
Navigating a ship that's already sunk.
La única esperanza para un mundo perdido.
The only hope for a world that's dying.
Es la cruz del Señor Jesucristo.
Is the cross of Jesus Christ.
Necesitamos anclar.
We have to anchor.
Nuestras iglesias.
Our churches.
Una vez más.
Once again.
A esa vieja cruz.
To that old rugged cross.
Áspera y decir con Pablo.
And to say along with Paul.
Lejos esté de mí golpearme. I'm far away from glorifying myself, sino en la cruz de nuestro Señor Jesucristo, I will glorify the cross of Jesus
Amen.
Christ.
Yes, Lord.
So termino diciendo.
So I end saying this.
Hay que visitar el Calvario.
We've got to visit Calvary again.
Lucas 23:33.
Luke 23:33 says.
Y cuando llegaron al lugar.
And when they were come to the place.
Que se llama Calvario.
Which is called Calvary.
Allí lo crucificaron a él.
There they crucified him.
Y a los malhechores.
And the malefactors.
Uno a la derecha.
One on the right hand.
Y el otro a la izquierda.
And the other on the left.
Oh, qué escenario más triste.
What a sad scene.
Para aquel que no entiende.
For those that don't understand.
Pero entendiendo ahora.
But understanding now.
El poder de la cruz.
The power of the cross.
El Calvario.
Calvary.
Es donde venimos.
Is where we go.
Con nuestros pecados.
For our sins.
Y nos convertimos en la justicia de Dios.
And we become the justice of God.
Del Calvario.
On Calvary.
Es donde venimos con nuestras amarguras.
Is where we come with our bitterness.
Y recibimos la dulzura de
and
Cristo.
And we receive the sweetness of Christ.
El Calvario.
Calvary.
Es donde venimos.
Is where we come.
En la oscuridad.
In darkness.
Y recibimos la luz de Cristo.
And receive the light of Christ.
En el Calvario.
Calvary
es donde
is where
venimos con nuestra culpa
we come with our guilt
y recibimos la gracia de Cristo.
And receive the grace of Christ.
Es donde estamos con nuestra sentencia de muerte.
It's where we come with our death sentence.
Y recibimos el perdón de Cristo.
And we receive Christ's forgiveness.
Es donde se aplasta la cabeza de Satanás.
It's where Satan's head is crushed.
Es donde se abre la fuente de la salvación.
Where the fountain of salvation is open.
Hacia donde los dedos de los profetas apuntan.
It's where the fingers of the prophets point.
Donde se revoca nuestra sentencia
it's
de muerte.
Where our death sentence is revoked.
Es el altar del sacrificio del cielo.
It becomes heaven's altar on earth.
Donde la cruz de Jesús se transformó.
Where the cross of Jesus was transformed.
Un altar.
Into an altar.
Donde el Cordero de Dios.
Where the sinless, spotless
sin
Lamb of
pecado,
God.
Impecable entregó su vida.
Gave his life.
Para redimir.
To redeem.
A la humanidad caída.
A fallen humanity.
Oh iglesia.
Oh church,
la cruz,
the cross,
es donde vemos al hombre,
where we see man,
en su peor momento,
in his worst moment.
Y a Dios.
And God.
En su mejor momento.
At his best.
Lo voy a decir de nuevo.
I'm going to say it again.
Es en la cruz.
On the cross.
Donde vemos al hombre.
Is where we see man.
En su peor momento.
In his worst moment.
Pero vemos a Dios.
But we see God.
En su mejor momento.
In his best moment.
Yo tengo que regresar a la cruz.
I've got to go back to the cross.
Yo tengo que regresar al Calvario.
I've got to go back to Calvary.
Yo quiero gloriarme en la cruz.
I want a glory in the cross.
No la cruz del hombre.
Not the cross of man.
Sino la cruz de Jesucristo.
But the cross of Jesus Christ.
Yo quiero levantar el mensaje de la cruz.
I want to raise up the message
of Jesus. Yo quiero vivir el mensaje de la cruz.
I want to live the message of
Jesus. Yo quiero ser santificado a través de la cruz.
I want to be sanctified by the cross.
Esa sangre que fue derramada.
That blood that was shed.
Pueda seguir limpiándome.
Could keep on cleaning me.
Purificándome.
Purifying me.
Santificándome.
Sanctifying me.
Día y noche.
Day and night.
Donde quiera que yo vaya.
Wherever I go.
En cualquier momento.
In every moment.
Santifícame.
Sanctify me.
La cruz es donde el cielo se inclinó.
The cross is where heaven bowed.
En tierno amor.
In tender love.
Y el infierno se desahogó.
And hell vented.
En su rabia más caliente.
In his hottest rage.
La cruz es donde la rosa de Sarón.
The cross is where the rose of Sharon.
Fue aplastada.
Was crushed.
Entre dos espinas de pecado.
By two thorns of sin.
La cruz es donde el lirio de los valles.
The cross is where the lily of the valley.
Brillaba.
Sparkled.
En todo su pureza.
In all its purity.
En medio del esterco y el fango de la iniquidad.
Amidst the muck and the mire of iniquity.
La cruz es donde.
The cross is where.
La misericordia y la
mercy
verdad.
Mercy and truth.
Se fusionan.
Fused together.
Y la justicia y la paz.
And justice and peace.
Se abrazan.
Embrace each other.
Es la cruz.
It's at that cross.
Donde un rayo.
Where a ray of light.
Brilló en medio de la oscuridad.
Beamed in the midst of darkness.
Mientras las gotas rojas de sangre,
while the ruby red beads of blood,
goteaban de las venas de Emmanuel,
dripped from Emmanuel's veins.
Gracias, Jesús.
Thank you, Jesus.
Por morir,
for dying,
en nuestro lugar,
in our place.
¿Se atreven a ponerse de pie en este momento?
Would you dare stand to your feet with me at this moment?
Hay que visitar la cruz.
We've got to visit the cross.
La cruz no pierde su poder.
The cross doesn't lose its power.
Ni tampoco se convierte insignificante.
Nor does it become insignificant.
En el momento de nuestra salvación.
In the moment of our salvation.
Es la fuente.
It's the fountain.
Que nos santifica.
That sanctifies us.
Es por esa sangre derramada.
It's by that shed blood.
Que limpia todos nuestros pecados.
That all of our sins are cleaned away.
Blanqueando nuestras almas.
Whitening our souls.
Para ponernos antes de su presencia.
To once again come before his presence.
Como siervos.
As servants.
Con privilegio.
With privileges.
De acercarse al trono de la gracia.
To be able to come to the throne of grace.
Inclinarnos.
And to bow.
Oh, reconociendo.
Recognizing.
El poder.
The power.
De aquel.
Of he.
Que fue a la cruz.
That went to the cross. Oh my God. Mm.
Santificaos, iglesia.
Sanctified. Sanctification, church. Be holy, church.
Yo no sé quién está aquí en este día.
I don't know who's in this place today.
Pero quiero, no quiero perder la oportunidad.
But I don't want to miss the opportunity.
De convocar a nuestros amigos.
To call on our friends.
Nuestros amigos que están presentes.
The friends that are present.
Y aquellos que nos están oyendo.
And those that are listening.
A través de la grabación.
Through live stream or virtual.
Este es el día de salvación.
This is the day of salvation.
La cruz.
The cross.
Si ponemos en formas de prioridad.
If we put it in a form of priority.
Fue para salvar.
Was to save.
So antes de llamar lo que quieren santificar,
so before we want to call those who are seeking holiness,
llamo a aquellos que necesitan salvación.
I want to call those who need salvation.
Hoy celebramos.
Today we celebrate.
El acto más inmenso.
The most immense act.
De un Dios que nos amó.
Of a God who loved us.
Y se entregó.
And gave himself.
Oh, por ti.
For you.
Y por mí.
And for me.
Su amigo que me escucha.
So my friend who hears me today.
Este es el día de tu salvación.
Today is the day of your salvation.
Yo me alegro.
And I rejoice.
Que hoy es un día de salvación.
That today is the day of salvation.
Y lo hizo por ti.
And he did it for you.
Los que me están escuchando.
Those of you that are hearing me.
Pueden inclinarse allí mismo donde
you
están.
Can bow right there where you are.
Y entregar su vida al Señor.
And give your life to the Lord.
Es cuestión de decir.
It's just by saying.
Yo confieso.
I confess.
Que Jesucristo,
that Jesus Christ,
es el Hijo de Dios viviente,
is the Son of the living God,
que Jesucristo,
that Jesus Christ,
murió por mí,
died for me,
y me ha perdonado,
and he has forgiven me,
y me ha dado,
and he has given me,
vida eterna,
eternal life,
si te atreves a decirlo,
and if that's you and you dare say that,
como le dijo,
like he told,
al pecador al lado de él,
the sinner who was standing next to him,
hoy,
who was on the cross next to him, today,
hoy,
today,
estará conmigo,
you're going to be with me
en el paraíso,
in paradise.
Hoy,
today.
Amigo que me escucha mientras hacemos el segundo llamado,
my friend who's hearing me as we make the second call,
por favor, no se detenga.
Don't wait.
Sino aprovechese.
Just take advantage.
Porque este segundo llamado,
because this second call,
es para aquellos,
is for those
que quieren llegar al Calvario,
that want to get to Calvary,
y santificarse un poco más,
and sanctify themselves just a little more.
Santificarse mucho más.
Or maybe sanctify yourself a little more, much more.
No debemos de rechazar la cruz.
We shouldn't reject the cross.
Porque solo a través de la cruz,
because it's only by the cross,
que podemos ser santificados,
that we can be sanctified.
Este es el día,
this is the day,
iglesia,
church,
para ser santificado,
to be sanctified.
Mientras el coro canta,
while the worship team sings,
abrimos el altar,
we open the altar,
para todos aquellos,
for those
que quieren decir,
that want to say,
me santifico hoy,
today I sanctify my life,
una vez más,
once again,
una vez más,
once again,
una vez más,
once again,
una vez más. Come on, sing with me, Señor.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for this. Father, in the name of Jesus, we are so grateful. So many of us have experienced the power of the cross in ways that amazes us, greater beyond our expectations. And it's so good that a day like today, we can confess and declare that the power of the cross is still working among us. Holy Spirit, if it were not for you, we would not be able to sustain, oh God, the life that we sustain as a body called church. So thank you, Holy Spirit, for sustaining us, for being and abiding in us, that we may give testimony of Jesus, the crucified Jesus. Oh, but even greater so, the resurrected Christ. That every day, as we approach the cross, that we may do it with a humble and contrite spirit. And in doing so, that we may be sanctified to the glory of your name. In Jesus' name. Come on, give somebody, give him a praise. Give him thanks. Give him praise, give him thanks. Come on, you can do better than that. I know you can do better than that. I'm talking about the King of Kings and the Lord of all. Would you give him what he's worthy? Give him what he's worthy tonight. Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Blessed the name of Jesus.
Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Clap your hands again for joy.
Hallelujah.
Unto the Lord as we give him praise. We thank God for his word to our hearts tonight. We thank God for delivering a word to us, a word in season. And I pray that we will not procrastinate when we hear the word of God come forth, but that lives will be transformed and changed by the power of the word of God. We want to thank Dr. Garcia and his wife, Lady Jenny, for ministering to us tonight. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for your servants who have ministered and have poured out tonight. We pray, Father, that you would minister to them and you would download into their spirits another word for tomorrow evening and for Sunday, Lord, so that when they come, they deliver the word that will set free, the word that will transform, and the word that will deliver in the power of the Holy Spirit. We thank you and we praise you and we honor you, Father, in Jesus' name. And all of God's people say, amen. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Just want to thank you all so much for being here this evening. And the ushers are waiting on us because they know that here at West Toronto, when we are blessed, we bless. It's a slogan we use. And I'm going to ask you, as the ushers come, we're going to just give an offering as we bless our guest speakers for coming this evening and for sharing the word of the Lord with us. And we share our gratitude in this way with them. And then we're going to sing the blessing and we're going to be out of here until tomorrow evening at 6:30. May I invite you all to just come now. You can move from where you are. You can go ahead and just walk on up here now. And let's do this. And then we're going to do the blessing and we're going to go. And we want to bless the man of God and the woman of God that has come to us this evening. Bless the name of the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord. And after we do the blessing, we're going to invite the ministers and their spouses to meet with us in the green room. It is the third room on your right. Just the ministers and their spouses, pastors and ministers and their spouses. May I invite you all to stand as we're people are continuing to come on up But come on up. I'm going to ask you to just stand, because we're singing the blessing while you're coming. Let's sing the blessing while everyone is coming. Praise the Lord.
The Lord bless you and heal you.
Bless someone as we sing. As you sing, just bless someone. As we sing this benediction over each other. Let's sing the blessing.
Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
See you tomorrow evening at 6:30. 6 o'clock is our pre-service prayer. You may join us for prayer.
What an impactful service. We thank God for moving so powerfully in our midst and delivering such a rich and challenging word to our hearts through his servants, Bishop Juan Garcia and Reverend Jenny Garcia. We ask you to meet us back here tomorrow at 6:30 p.m. as we continue to celebrate the death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ.
We believe that God will keep speaking through us throughout the weekend. We hope that he can transform our hearts as we draw closer to him. Thank you, everybody, for coming tonight.
We see you tomorrow.